Let us close the eyes for a moment. Praying to God and Masters. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahano Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvi Navadhitamastu मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्तिः 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 मे गॉड प्रोटेक्ट अस ऑल मे वी एंजॉय फूड टुगेदर मे वी मेडिटेट एंड प्रे टुगेदर मे वी अटेन विजडम थ्रू आवर स्टडी एंड डिस्कशन May there be no conflict among us. May there be peace everywhere. Om. Amen. I bow to one God who is formless. I bow to all the saints and sages and all the masters of Kriya Yuga lineage. And I bow to each one of you. Om. Amen. Good morning and welcome. To this satsang. In Yoga Sutra Patanjali, second book, 18th verse, speaks about the nature of manifested divinity and the enjoyment and liberation. So I'll share with you this beautiful verse. In this verse, Sage Patanjali is saying, Prakasha Kriya Sthiti Shilam Bhutendriyatmakam Bhogapavargartham Drashyam. The knowable is of the nature of illumination, activity, and inertia, consisting of the elements. And sense organs. Its objects are for experiencing the world and emancipation. So three sections are there: Prakasha, Kriya, Sthiti Shila. Knowable is of the nature of illumination, activity, and inertia, which is like Jnana Shakti, Kriya Shakti, Ichha Shakti. Then Bhuta Indriya Atmaka, consisting of the elements and sense organs. Then comes bhoga apavarga artham. Bhoga means for experiencing or enjoying, apavarga for emancipation. So bhoga apavarga, these two words we are going to discuss today. Bhoga means enjoyment through the senses. And apavarga means liberation or emancipation. This bhoga word is derived from the verb in Sanskrit bhuj. Bhuj means to eat, to enjoy, to rule, to govern. Therefore, bhoga means eating, enjoying, ruling, and governing. And apavarga is from the root verb apavrij, means to avoid, to avert. Apavrijyate samsara muchyate anena kriya vasana safalya moksha. That which makes one free from the world by bringing an end to all activities is real success. This is nothing but moksha, freedom, emancipation, liberation, completion, or fulfillment. So, all the visible objects, which are basically the play of triple divine qualities of nature, sattva, rajas, and tamas, consisting of gross and subtle elements, the sense organs, including the mind, intellect, memory, and ego, are only for two purposes: either enjoyment or experience the world, or fulfillment and liberation. So in this word, apavarga, a is suffix, a is prefix. A is prefix and pavarga is the word. A means negation and pavarga means experiencing the world through sense organs. So pavarga, those who are familiar with Sanskrit grammar and alphabets in Sanskrit and Devanagari script, we have 16 vowels, 34 consonants. So in consonants, there are 5 groups, vargas, depending on the pronunciation from a different part of the mouth. They are known as ka varga, cha varga, ta varga, ta varga, and pa varga. So in the pa group, there are 5 letters, pa, pha, ba, bha, ma. In our Sanskrit classes, our Swamiji has taught you. So, pa varga in Devanagari script, pa, pha, ba, bha, ma. It has interesting quality. Each letter involves opening one's mouth. If you see, pa, pha, ba, bha, ma, you're opening the lips. So, pa varga means they have taken material life in different aspects. Let us discuss. Pa. First letter is pa. What is pa? In material life, pa is parishrama, means hard labor. We all are working very hard, day and night. We exert, we are exhausted, but we are working hard to maintain our family, to earn some money, to fulfill our legitimate desires. So this is parishrama, hard labor. Then second letter is pha. When we do hard labor, sometimes foam comes out of our mouth. So pha is here, phena. Phena means foam. We have seen from the mouth of horse, cows, bulls, and dogs, foam coming out. Sometimes, when we also have foam, our tongue becomes dry after working very hard. So there are foams when we speak. This is pha, phena. Third letter is ba. So let me share with you the screen. These letters, pa, 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 bha, ma. Third letter is ba. Ba means bandhana or bondage. Bha means bhaya or fear. Ma means mrityu or death. So third one is ba. Ba means bondage. We all are free. Although we are free, but we feel as if we are bound, just like Arjuna. A-Rajuna means one who is free but still feels he is bound. We create our own bondage. Although we are free, but we always feel as if we are bound in this world with our desires, with our relations, with so many conditions. The next letter is Bha. Bha means bhaya. Bhaya means fear. We are always fearful. In Mahabharata, there is a verse, Ahara nidra bhaya methunam cha samanam etat pashubhi naranam. Between or among the animals and humans, 4 things are common. Ahara means hunger. Nidra is the sleep. Bhaya is the fear. And maithuna, physical relationship. These are common between animals and humans. However, every conditioned soul is subjected to fearfulness. What will happen next? Even great politician is under fear. How these people will drive me away? So, this fear must be there. Hard labor for election, then rejection, and then fearfulness. Whether my position or my job will remain tomorrow or not, this is the fear. Nobody is free. Even the demigods have fear. It is said, Bhayam dvitiya abhiniveshatah syat. Scripture say, when one is attached to the other thing except God, which is dvitiya, then he or she is fearful. Because God is one. Ekam brahma dvitiyo nasti. When one is not God realized, the other realized means illusion realized. Then there is fear. So, pa, pha, ba, bha, ma, and the last letter is ma. Ma means mrityu or death. Without attaining realization, we die. We live as if we are not going to die, but ultimately one day we have to leave this body, leave this world. So we die without fulfilling the purpose of our life, without attaining goal of life. So this is called pa, pha, pa, bha, ma, pa group or pa varga. So if we want to be free, we need apavarga, means negation of pavarga, which is called apavarga liberation. There is a beautiful verse in scripture, and this verse tells about the sun. Arogyam bhaskarat ichhet, shriyam ichhet hutashanat, jnanam maheshwarat ichhet, moksham ichhet janardanat. One should desire health from the sun. Sun means sun salutation. Early morning we do some exercises, sun salutation, Surya Namaskar. So health is from sun. Also, vitamin D required for our body is from the sun rays. Then prosperity from fire or yajna. So when we perform fire ceremony, we fulfill our material desires. Knowledge, we should ask from Lord Shiva, and liberation from Lord Narayana. So, when we talk about Lord Shiva, there is interesting verse in another scripture which is related to Pavarg and Lord Shiva. Each letter of Pavarg is related to one aspect of Lord Shiva. So, I'll share that verse with you. You have seen the family of Lord Shiva living on Mount Kailash with his family, two sons and mother Parvati. So the verse is Parvati Fani Balendu Bhasma Mandakini Yuta Apavarga Pradamurtihi Katham Syat Tavashankara. O Lord Shiva, your form is full of Pavarga. How shall that form attached to these things be the bestower of apavarga, means moksha or liberation? What is pavarga for Lord Shiva? Parvati, the first line, Parvati, Fani, Balendu, Bhasma, Mandakini. So what is Parvati? Parvati is his consort of Lord Shiva. Pa stands for Parvati. So in Hindu scriptures, Mother Parvati is very embodiment of love and affection for husband. It is this trait of hers that made Lord Shiva merge into her and be known as Ardhanarishwara, Lord as one half of Parvati. So this is for association with Parvati, Mother Parvati. Then second is pha. Pha stands for fun. Fun is not here the not English one, but this is pha. Here it is hood. Lord Shiva is typically depicted with a snake wrapped around his neck and with its hood upright like this. In our day-to-day life, we meet many negative-minded or harmful personalities. Often, we cannot close our eyes and imagine that they will go away. Sometimes, they have to be picked up and carried along too, however disturbing their personality and habits are. In the course of time, it is quite possible that their behavior will undergo a transformation, so much so that they can be carried along agreeably as calmly as Lord Shiva carries the snake on his neck. So snake is the symbol of dormant energy in the Muladhara Chakra, bottom center. So here, pha is the fun, hood of the snake. Then third letter is ba. Ba stands for Balendu. There are two words, Bala Indu. Indu is the moon. Bala means small. So it refers to the crescent moon near Lord Shiva's forehead. This moon is supposed to be the moon of second day after the new moon day. This day is considered extremely auspicious by Hindus. And therefore, Lord Shiva also brings along with him an element of auspiciousness. Moreover, just as crescent moon blossoms into full moon, we too must strive hard to do more auspicious work, as that would help us to transform. Extending the cyclical nature of moon's appearance, increasing up to the full moon day, we need to learn and grow in knowledge every day. This is the symbol of crescent moon to remain in light of knowledge. Fourth letter is bha. Bha refers to bhasma. Bhasma means ashes that Lord Shiva is smeared with. Typically, ash is applied on the forehead and is considered holy. And this attribute of Lord Shiva instructs us to become so pious and pure that people treat us with the same holiness. So much even the ashes one day become holy for this world. Putting on ashes on the body and forehead is the symbol to remember that this life is impermanent like ripples on water, and one day this beautiful body will turn into handful of ashes. So bha is bhasma. Last letter is ma. Ma refers to Mandakini, another name for the holy river Ganga. Lord Shiva is also depicted as the primal origin of Ganga, holding her on top of his head. Hindus all over the world believe that a dip in the waters of river Ganga results in all their accumulated sins being washed away. And this attribute of Lord Shiva enjoins us to have the transforming character of Ganga, so that just by coming into contact with us, everyone changes for the better. So this is pa, pha, ba, bha, ma with relation to Lord Shiva. He is having all this material prosperity, pa varga. Then how his form can give us apavarga liberation? However, he grants us liberation. More generally, the family of Lord Shiva presents a fascinating picture of harmonious coexistence among entities commonly regarded as natural foes in the animal world. If you see Lord Shiva, his vehicle or his carrier is bull. Mother Parvati's vehicle is lion, and they are enemies. Similarly, the two sons Kartikeya and Lord Ganesha. Kartikeya has peacock and Lord Ganesha has mouse, and they are also not friendly. And on top of this, they are present along with the snake on Lord Shiva's neck. So you see, each one is enemy to other, but they live together, and this is the best example of peaceful coexistence, accepting each other's qualities but living in peace. Now come to our Kriya practice. In Kriya practice also, we have this power, because we have this pavarga and we need apavarga. So apavarga means moksha or liberation. So pavarga in Kriya practice is, pa stands for pranayama and paravastha. Pa is fontanel. Ba means bow, and bha is brahmari, listening to divine sound, which is nothing but om technique. And the last one is ma, is mahamudra and meditation. So what is pavarga? In Kriya practice, remaining in fontanel, listening to divine sound, practice bow, mahamudra and pranayama, then meditate to feel presence of divine or become one with divine in paravastha. So all the techniques are included in pavarga. When we practice them, we get apavarga. Apavarga means moksha, liberation, freedom. Freedom from thoughts, freedom from desires, freedom from all conditionings of body and mind, and we become one with divine, which is apavarga. So this is pavarga related to our Kriya practice. However, we are delayed today, so we will meditate for some time now. Wherever you are sitting, please sit straight. So let us meditate for some time. Wherever you are sitting, keep your spine straight. Close the eyes. In between the eyebrows, we call it third eye or soul center. Concentrate with love. Just become aware of your body, your cutting off, detaching yourself from the external world, gradually from body consciousness, turn your attention to the breath. Every moment we are breathing, every breath is breath of divine. Watch every single breath. Initially, you may feel little friction in the nostrils. Observe incoming breath, outgoing breath. Gradually, you may feel thoughts are reducing. Just feel relaxed. Now, let us enter the inner shrine of divine through this breath. We will practice a couple of deep breaths. From top of your head to bottom of the spine, slow, long, deep breathing. With inhalation, let us feel that all the positive qualities are entering. Love. And when we exhale, let us feel that all negativities are going away from us. We are emanating peace. Please inhale slow, long, deep. Love. Exhale. Peace. Inhale. Love. Exhale, peace, inhale, love, exhale, peace, inhale, peace, exhale, love, inhale, peace, exhale, love, inhale, love, exhale, peace, inhale, love, exhale, peace, normal conscious breath. Your body is completely steady. Mind becomes peaceful. Breath is so slow. Remaining in the third eye, meditate in silence. Experiencing a blissful state of avarga, freedom from thoughts, freedom from fear, from all conditionings, just love. Let us extend this peace in the whole cosmos. Praying for all. Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinaha Sarve Santo Niramayaha Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu Ma Kaschid Dukkha Bhag Bhavet Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. May all become happy and healthy, loving, noble and compassionate. Let there be no suffering or sorrow. Let there be more love, peace, harmony among us and in this whole creation. Om. Amen. Gently open the eyes. Thank you all for joining in this satsang and meditation. Meditate nicely. Your free soul remain in Apavarga. Meditate and be realized, be liberated. Thank you all for the next time.